This video explains the observations in elasticities of supply. We have seen different kinds of elasticities. Now let's recall them and see where they all apply in these diagrams. So the first one, elasticity supply is equal to 1. That is unitary elastic supply curves. So all these curves are unitary elastic supply curves. How do you say that? The supply curves which are straight line and pass through the origin have unitary elastic supply irrespective of the angles they make with the origin. So they are straight line, start passing through the origin, so they have unitary elastic supply. So it is irrespective of the angle they make in the origin. So here you find A, B, C are the supply curves of the three different commodities. The price elasticity of supply for all the three curves is equal to 1. Although A is steeper and C is flatter, but elasticity will be equal to 1. That means they are straight. Any straight line supply curve which passes through the origin has unitary elastic supply, irrespective of the angle it makes with the origin. So that is what the first diagram says. Now we'll see the second diagram. You find flatter curve and you find steeper. The flatter curve, more is the elasticity at the point of intersection. Here you find supply curves SS is flatter and S1 intersect SS curve at E. They intersect each other at point E. So at point E, OQ quantity is supplied. OQ quantity is supplied at the price of OP. When price falls from OP to OP1, the quantity supplied falls from OQ to OQ1. Here you find OQ, Q1, Q2. So let's first see the OQ2. When price falls from OP to OP1, you find the quantity OQ2. For supply curve SS, initially I said Q1. The Q1 is for S1. For SS curve, you find when price falls to OP1, the quantity supplied is OQ2 for SS curve, and from OQ to OQ1 for supply curve S1. So with the same change in price, that is PP1, PP1, you find change in supply in case of supply curve. Change in supply is OQ2. In case of supply curve, S is more than change in supply OQ1. OQ2. Under the supply curve, S1. So it means supply is more elastic in case of SS. That means, how do you say that? Because when it intersects this price line, you find here OQ2. That is, the quantity of unit supplied decreases. and as compared to S1, S1. So you see S1, S1 curve, this is the quantity supplied, OQ1. So which is less, OQT is less. So here you find which supply curve makes OQ2 supply. Here you find S makes OQ2. So here you find the flatter curve is more elastic because the flatter curve SS, you can find OQ2 is the quantity supplied, which is less than OQ1. The OQ1 is for S1, S1 supply curve. So S1, S1 is steeper curve and flatter curve is more elastic. So here you find both the curves giving the steeper and flatter curve shows how do they make the elasticity of supply. Now next one, next diagram you find here x-axis a quantity supplied, y-axis price. This is a recall of what we have already learnt. So here you find S1, S1. I'll start from this one, which is elastic supply is equal to 0. That means perfectly inelastic. That means same quantity supplied at all prices, same quantity. So here you find next S1 version you have seen. Then you'll see SS. Elasticity of supply is equal to infinity. So here infinity you find perfectly elastic. Infinite supply at same price. The next one, S2. Elastic supply is less than 1. So when you say elastic supply is less than 1, you find percentage change in supply is less than percentage change in price. Then we'll see S3. Elastic supply is more than greater than 1. That means less elastic. So percentage change in supply is less than percentage change in price. Next S4. Elastic supply is equal to 1, which is unitary elastic. Percentage change in supply is equal to percentage change in price. So these are the observations we have made in supply, elasticity of supply. Now we'll see supply of commodity cannot be changed overnight. So it takes time to change the supply. And time has been divided into 3 periods. It is very short period and long period. So now we'll see very short period, this one. The market period refers to a very short period in which the supply cannot be changed in response to change in demand. So the supply of a commodity takes time to adjust itself to change in the demand condition. So in the market period, supply is limited. Like in case of vegetables, fruits, you cannot make it overnight. Fruits, milk, etc. Therefore, the supply curve is straight line, parallel to y-axis. So here, the supply is perfectly inelastic in very short period. The next one, supply is less elastic in short period. This is very long short period, this is short period. So you find quantity supplied is represented on x-axis, then price is represented on y-axis. So short period refers to a period in which output can be changed by changing only variable factors. So supply is less responsive to changes in demand. The supply curve is less elastic in short period. The next one, long period, highly elastic. Fine, x-axis or quantity supplied, y-axis represents price. Long period refers to a period in which supply can be changed by changing all factors of production. Therefore, supply becomes more responsive to change in demand because they have enough time to change all the factors of production. So they can the supply also increases according to the demand. So the supply curve is elastic in long period because all factors of production can be increased. When demand is more, the supply can be more because of the time given. So here supply is highly elastic in long period. In very short period, you cannot increase the supply in a short period. That is why it is inelastic.